Now these were the big guys in the water. We talk about T-Rex being on the land, being the big carnivore, but you know, T-Rex didn't go in the water with one of these guys. He'd have been toast. And we always relate plesiosaurs, the long-necked variety, to the Loch Ness monster.
Million years ago, South Dakota looked a lot different than it does today. It was covered by the Great Interior Seaway, and it held a treasure trove of fantastic marine reptiles.
So there was a whole host of unbelievably bizarre creatures that lived here in South Dakota toward the end of the Age of Reptiles.
There's no better place to learn about the ancient marine reptiles of South Dakota than the Museum of Geology in Rapid City, where visitors can see the full size and scope of these giants of the sea, the fish-eating plesiosaur, and the ferocious mosasaur.
And he ate anything he wanted to eat. We have specimens here in the Museum of Geology that include fish in the stomachs, possibly sharks, big diving birds that are stood about 3 foot high, and even other mosasaurs. So they were eating their own kind. They weren't quite cannibals because they weren't eating the exact same species, but they were eating the same genera or similar genera. And so it'd be kind of like us eating a monkey rather than one another. But they would definitely take on almost anything that swam in the ocean during the end of the Age of Dinosaurs.
The specimen on display at the museum was found in northeastern South Dakota and is just one example of the many kinds of mosasaurs found in the region.
The mosasaurs, the top-end carnivores, were very, very diverse. Just to give you an example, here's a typical mosasaur jaw, and you can see the very, very nice sharp teeth with nice serrations on the edge of these knife blades. And this was a typical mosasaur. This is Mosasaurus itself. And this animal was definitely able to eat almost any kind of meat. But another type of mosasaur is represented by this jaw. Here is a mosasaur called Globidens. Globa means kind of globular, dens means tooth, and you can see the teeth are much different in their morphology or their shape than these very sharp mosasaur teeth of Mosasaurus. This animal was crushing its prey, not slicing through it like a scissors, but crushing it. And this particular specimen, we actually found the Last Supper in the stomach of it as well, and it was crushing huge, big clams. So it was getting oyster on the half shell clear back in the Cretaceous.
Like the mosasaur, there was a variety of plesiosaurs that swam the ancient seaway.
There was a very short-necked variety. We call it a short-necked plesiosaur. And instead of having a real long neck and a small head, it had a very short neck, but a huge long skull, you know, a meter long, over 3 feet long, very often. And both the long neck variety and the short neck variety, all were fishermen. They were the true fishermen of the sea. Of course, mosasaurs ate fish as well, but plesiosaurs were really adapted for eating fish. The long neck types were probably ambush predators that lay in wait for fish and used optical illusions to capture their prey. Whereas the short neck type with the long heads were built for speed. They essentially flew through the water, much like penguins fly through the water today. But in addition to having pectoral fins or shoulder fins, they also had paddles in the rear. So it's like having a supercharger. And these things could really go through the water at high rates of speeds and run down their fish.
Dr. Martin, along with volunteers and help from the Army Corps of Engineers, is currently in the process of excavating a short-necked plesiosaur. It was discovered along the Missouri River in central South Dakota.
This particular site, James Lindley from the Corps of Engineers found the plesiosaur, and other folks that were working with him, Bob, Mitch, they found the mosasaur. Our students then found another mosasaur, and it's just snowballed in this one little area. But it all started with the Corps reporting fossils to the Museum of Geology.
In some areas, the excavation work is a very delicate process.
We've been working on excavating this piece right here, which Dr. Martin believes is part of the paddle of the plesiosaur that's fallen down the cliff. We found a couple other pieces down here, 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 and here. which we're really not sure exactly what they are yet. And most of it's pretty fragile since it's fallen down the side of the cliff.
In other instances, more heavy machinery is brought in to cut through the tough stuff.
It's a mosasaur of some type. It's kind of embedded in this chalk rock, and it's hard to get her dug out.
There's another mosasaur excavation at this site up along a cliff. The location of the fossil tells paleontologists much about these creatures, including why did these great sea monsters vanish from the face of the earth?
And all of them became extinct right at the end of the Age of Reptiles. And there's really lots of questions as to how and why the marine creatures in particular became extinct. But we do have some real interesting clues here in South Dakota. Now, these animals are air breathing. Even though they're in the marine realm, they're coming up to the surface to get a big gulp of air and then dive back down to get on with whatever they're doing. Well, almost half or even more of the specimens we've found have been found associated with bentonite. They're laying either right above or below a bentonite layer. Some of these bentonite layers can be 3 foot thick. Bentonite is just altered volcanic ash. So these bentonites represent volcanic explosions that happened over farther west in what was starting to become the Rocky Mountains. This ash is blowing out into this seaway. Well, if you have 3 feet of ash, that probably meant you had about 3 feet of bentonite. You had about 24 feet of ash covering this whole seaway. So if you're coming up to get a nice little gulp of fresh air and you end up getting glass shards and poison gas and all kinds of goodies like that, you're probably not going to survive very easily. And we find this to be the case many, many times, and even additional evidence to show that these animals were in the peak of health is that many of the animals we find associated with bentonites still have the Last Supper inside. They still have stomach contents showing that they were healthy, active predators, very capable of survival. But something catastrophic put an end to many of these very, very large reptiles.
60 million years later, the landscape of South Dakota has changed drastically into rolling prairies and spruce-covered hills. But the great sea creatures of long ago will forever be a presence in this region.
So South Dakota is paradise when it comes to finding and understanding these giant marine reptiles.